The pros are getting ready to get going. We have an exciting new addition to our WUSA9 sports team that we're going to introduce to you this morning.
That's right. I'm just excited about all of the tailgating we're going to do. But without further ado, let's introduce Darren Haynes, our brand new WUSA9 sports director and anchor. Woo! And look at that. I mean, he comes in with a bang, right?
Oh, look at the hoverboard.
All right, I'm ready. Go long, Darren.
I can keep doing this all day long. Oh, I got to throw it to you?
Yeah, you have
don't
to
mess
throw
up,
it to
don't
you.
Mess up, don't mess up.
Oh,
that's what I'm
man.
Talking about.
Oh, come on, Darren. I could have done better than that.
Can we do this again?
Yeah.
You go over there, Mr. Darren.
I try to catch it with one hand. Oh, and
try to ODB it.
Hey, before we get started, that is not one of the hoverboards that blow up. So
that's
we are
good.
Safe.
Okay,
that's good.
We are safe.
We don't want that in the studio.
And I wore the glasses because you told me about a guy who lost an eye catching a football on TV.
Well, I threw it at the numbers, so you're good.
All right.
And then I tried the one hand, and I failed, but it's all right.
Well, welcome to WUSA9.
Happy to be here.
We're
happy
so
to be
happy
here. Excited.
Here.
Usually during this time, I'm in my third dream, but but it's all right. I'm awake, ready to go.
Now you came to us from ESPN.
Yeah. It was a great opportunity up in Bristol, Connecticut.
Yeah.
I was anchoring Sports Center, but now I'm here in this city. I have family out in Prince George's County.
So I'm
really excited. This is a sports city. You have every single professional team here.
Right.
All that in a bag of chips. So I'm really excited to get started here. I start next week Tuesday, so it's gonna be a little bit different. The fans are gonna enjoy it big time.
Nothing like throwing you right into football season.
I know,
right? What better way is there to start?
It's the perfect time to start because you're a former football player yourself. Now you started.
I had a little something back in the day.
We didn't see it over there with the missed catch, but you were good. You were good.
There you go. High school. Is that your high school or your college?
You know what? That is high school. I wish you guys could like blur out the dreads, but that was like a superstitious thing. Like I felt like if I cut those dreads off, I wouldn't score any touchdowns.
Okay.
You know, I cut it off in college. That's why I didn't make the NFL.
What?
I'm just saying, blame it on that hair.
Athletes are very superstitious in that way, right? Okay, what else were you superstitious about?
Listening to the same music every single day, same socks. I was very weird with it because actually Pop Warner, Captain Crunch Crunchberries.
Okay.
Ate that during Pop Warner.
Uh-huh.
I did the same thing all the way into my last college football game.
All right.
That's weird.
That is, yeah, but it's interesting.
To each their own, right?
Yeah.
To each their own. Well, you talked about the Redskins, and I mean, you obviously know all about them being at ESPN and being there, but what are you looking forward to most about jumping into this season?
I have high expectations for the Redskins, and I'm sure everybody else does. Let's not talk about that third preseason game as far as any offense, but, you know, if a team wins, we win. When the team is very successful, that makes our job easier. You know that.
Yes.
But we like to
report on happy things. We like to report on victories.
Listen, D.C. people, DMV, it's going to be different this year. The Redskins, let's hope they play very, very well and they win a playoff game. Let's hope the Capitals, they make it into the Stanley Cup finals.
And
let's hope the Nationals make a look. Hey, I'll make it simple. Let's win a playoff series. There's some big things that can change this season. I'm looking forward to it. Maybe I'm like the good luck charm.
All the teams are on the cusp. So, yeah, maybe you're bringing that little extra
just a little, just
for that.
Just a little
good
push.
Luck. You have to kind of pass on some of those superstitious activities to some of our
sports. No, it's not going to work
for them. Especially the Redskins here. But let's go back to you. You're a family man, right?
I am, very much so.
You have a daughter. You're getting married. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that's.
There she is.
Yeah, that's
cute.
She's the sun. I'm just the planet revolving around her.
What's her name?
Her name's Joelle. She's 5, going on 25. Oh, that's my fiance. She's smoking hot. she's actually in Houston. She was stuck out there because of Hurricane Harvey. They had to actually the fire department had to come in and help evacuate her. And then she was in a shelter for a couple of days, sleeping on cardboard.
You said she was. How is she doing today?
She's good. Actually, yesterday and today, she was safe and then went back out and was helping people in the community. She was knocking down sheetrock to kind of help restore some houses and stuff like that. So it's just amazing. She just felt like she needed to do that. People helped her, so why don't I do that back?
She wants to help others.
Yeah.
And you have your engagement party coming up.
I do. I fly out to Houston.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. So yeah, so I'm ready to party on Sunday. If y'all can make it, y'all better show up because it's gonna go down.
Okay, so the Houston family is okay. You're flying.
Yeah, Houston family is okay. And then my fiance will fly here on Tuesday. She has her job interview on Wednesday, and then you know the family. Family's here.
The family is here, and so is Darren.
I want us to show a video of your daughter watching you on television. It's the cutest thing. While you were anchoring at ESPN, she's just so proud of her papa. And she just, she was watching, right? And watching TV and knocking on it.
She was like, hi, Daddy. Hi, Daddy.
Through the television.
And what was so crazy about it is that actually was my last show. That was my last time on SportsCenter before, you know, they had the layoffs at ESPN. So it's now, you know, the next one I'm going to have now, next time I'm going to anchor will be on Tuesday. My daughter's going to be able to, I see you, Daddy.
I love it. Well, we live stream this show all over the country. Mm-hmm. So hopefully she's looking on the computer screen right now and she's knocking, hi, Daddy, because this is really your first time on television since your last day.
Yeah, that is very, very true. So I'm excited about that. The only thing, I just have one request, though. If I'm gonna do sports here, I have to roll in style. You saw the way I came in with the cheerleaders and stuff like that. Like, that has to be like an everyday thing.
Hey, well, listen, we're open because we love fun, and I'm not a sports fanatic, but I like the sports stories from a lifestyle standpoint. Mm-hmm. So I like the style. What are these guys wearing when they're coming out of the locker room?
You guys
are kind of slick.
Well, see, one thing we're gonna do for our new sportscast is we're gonna give fans a different view that they've never had before. We're gonna give them inside access, interviewing players in a totally different way you've never seen before. So I'm really excited about it. We're using some of those connections a little bit to make that happen. So it's gonna be different, opinionated, a lot of fun. You don't wanna miss it on Tuesday.
Well, we wanted to welcome you, Jade and Jacqueline, if y'all
bring
back
in.
Because
we're rolling style here.
We had to welcome
way. The sand and pants lets you know this guy is ready to have fun and make it a sports party, right? Now, before we let you go, one more thing about you. We heard you're a science geek.
I'm a science nerd.
So the eclipse was like a huge thing for you, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, I wanted to major in astronomy my freshman year of college. And then I ended up switching my major to broadcasting because my mother told me to, and she's like, now she wants 10% of my check. But yes, that is my little girl. And she loved it. She understood what what the moon was doing with the sun. And I really wanted to break down, like, hey, you know, with the black hole, with the gravitational pull, spaghettification. But she was like, I don't get that, Daddy. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, my gosh. Between the sports talk and the stars talk, I'm lost. I'm digging the salmon pants.
Yeah. We're happy to have you here for sure.
I'm glad Kristen and I fit in.
We'll see, Darren.
Redskins cheerleaders. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank y'all for coming in.
That's how we roll.
That's how we do.
I like it. We'll see you on the air on Tuesday.
All right.
Now.